Vada Pav is a popular, iconic street snack in Mumbai. Who doesn't love street food? Here I am presenting our super delicious, crunchy Vada Pav recipe. In this today's video, you'll be learning how to make special garlic chutney, green chutney, and the most important element, which is the heart of the recipe, Vada, made with potato and sandwich between pav. To start the recipe, let's make the garlic chutney first. We are gonna be making from scratch. So put sesame seeds, means dill, in a hot pan. Roast on medium heat for 2 minutes until roasted. Once done, add coconut powder. Also roast them on medium flame for 1 minute or until the roasted aroma starts coming. Then wipe out the pan to remove the tiny piece of coconut powder and add the next ingredient, that is peanuts. Roast them similarly. Then add garlic. The ingredients list will be found in the description below. When you see the brown spots on the garlic, that means it's well roasted. Stir it. Take them out. Once all the ingredients roasted and cooled down completely, put them in a mixer jar one by one. Additionally, include salt and red chili powder. Add black salt. Blend it, and our special garlic chutney is ready. This garlic chutney is dry and different from other chutneys. Now let's make green chutney. Very simple. In a blender jar, add mint leaves, means pudina, coriander leaves, means dhania, garlic pods, green chili, lemon juice, and salt. Blend it with 1 teaspoon of water. Don't add too much water because the leaves has its own water. While blending, they will also release their water. And here our green chutney is also ready. Now let's make the spicy potato mixture for vada. In a pan, add oil. Put mustard seeds, asafoetida, means hing, curry leaves, chopped garlic, ginger, chopped green chilies, and salt, and turmeric powder. Just a quick stir. Now add boiled potato, which was already mashed. Mix with the masala. And finish up with chopped coriander leaves. Let the aloo masala cool down. In the meantime, make the batter for vada. In a mixing bowl, add besan, means gram flour, chawal ka atta, means rice flour, baking soda. It helps the vada to be airy and light. Pour in 2.5 cups of water slowly. Make a smooth and thick batter. Finally, add 1 teaspoon hot oil. It will make the vada crispy. Using the same batter, you can make hundreds of vada, like anda vada or any vegetable vada. Keep the batter aside for 10 minutes. Here the potato mixture also cooled down. Make small lemon sized balls out of potato masala. Just roll between your palms and make a crack free smooth ball. Take 1 potato ball, dip in a thick batter, immediately slide in the hot oil. Once you put in the oil, don't stir the potato balls immediately. Wait for some time. Once it becomes golden brown, flip over. Repeat the same process. And you know, fry the opposite side. Once the both sides become golden brown, take out in a tissue paper and drain out excess oil. Using a whisk, splash the leftover batter in the hot oil. This is called chura. It is also served with vada pav. Fry them also till golden brown. Once done, take out and store. Now cut the pav in the center. Roast it slightly. Slightly roasting the pav adds crunchiness. Now let's assemble it. On one side of the pav, add green chutney. On another side of the pav, add tamarind chutney. Sprinkle dry garlic chutney. This garlic chutney, no, like awesome. Salty, little spicy, nutty, everything is there in the chutney. Keep an aloo vada on it. Now press it slightly with another side of the pav. Our vada pav is ready. Now serve this delicious vada pav with chura, onion and extra garlic chutney. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you like this recipe, please hit the like button, share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you soon. Till then, take care and bye.